want to elaborate on this power shift going on within the music industry. And the first thing is, you know, forget about a deal with a big label. You know, those just aren't out there anymore. What you need to look at is how to bring somebody on board to help you get started. That's going to help you build interaction with your fans. What is happening is we're redefining what it means to be successful in the music industry. So don't be thinking millions of dollars. With our tools, our mission is to create a new middle class of musicians so people can quit their job at Smoothie King. You want somebody on board who's going to help you start building interaction with your fans, because it's the static song that gets released, that gets pirated. Seth Godin has, a number of years ago, wrote an excellent book on permission marketing, and he's been blogging occasionally about the music industry recently. And one of the things that he points out is that you can't pirate interaction. Right? You can't just release a song and then think it's going to be popular. You've got to be blogging. You've got to be shooting video. You have to become like a television show that's episodic in nature. So like The Sopranos, when people watch one episode, they want to come back and they want to watch the next episode. You want to be able to do that with your fans. And that means over time building a staff that's going to help you do that. So I see a whole new segment of careers for people who, instead of working for the artists, they're going to be working for, instead of working for the label, they're going to be working for the artists. And they're going to be like producer, directors, script writers, the kind of things that are on YouTube. And YouTube has channels. A lot of people don't realize. I talk to almost everyone I talk to who's even a big user of YouTube has not gotten this channel concept. If you create your own channel on YouTube, that's a show. That's something that people will be coming back to. And as I've gone to MeetM and Digital Music Forum in New York just recently, what I hear people saying is it's not how much money you get per track, it's how much money you get out of their wallets. That's what counts in the end. So we need to be looking at the new ways to monetize things. And if you've got people, if you're creating a channel, you're creating a show, maybe the music itself is only selling a certain number of copies, but you get a show, you build a fan base that's loyal to you, then you can start thinking about advertising, product placement, licensing, and all kinds of deals.